Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Priya Sipaha. Today we are going to discuss grievous hurt. Although hurt and grievous hurt is very lengthy and it is started right from section 319 to section 338. That's why I am dividing these into three videos. In my previous video, I have already explained hurt. Now in this video, I will be explaining grievous hurt and some of the punishment of hurt and grievous hurt. So in this video, I will be explaining right from section 320 to 329. And in my next video, definitely I will explain right from section 330 to section 338. So let's start with grievous hurt. Section 320 of IPC deals with grievous hurt. Grievous hurt is basically an aggravated form of simple hurt. That means if any person is giving a damage or damaging anyone others or another's body in such a way that there is a permanent loss in his any of the body organ, or if there is a temporary loss, even that loss will extend up to at least 20 days, then it will come under the category of grievous hurt. Now there are 8 subsections which has been mentioned, or 8 categories has been mentioned under grievous hurt. Now the first category is emasculation. That means if anyone is causing hurt or making damage to any man, out of which a man become impotent, then it comes under the category of grievous hurt. Second category speaks about eyesight. If there is a temporary or permanent damage in the eyesight of any person, definitely that come under the category of grievous hurt. Thirdly, if there is any permanent or temporary loss in the hearing capability, that means anything damage in the ear, then also it comes under grievous hurt. Then if there is any damage in teeth, that also come into the category of grievous hurt. Then if there is damage on the face or head anywhere which persists long, then also it is category of grievous hurt. Then if there is a temporary or permanent hurt in the membrane or any joint of the body, it may be one joint, it may be more than one joint, then also it is grievous hurt. Then if there is any fracture and that fracture persists for at least for 20 days, then it comes under the category of grievous hurt. And lastly, if any sort of injury, if any sort of damage which has been caused to another person, which could endanger the life of that person, that is definitely come under the category of grievous hurt. So these are the 8 categories which has been mentioned under section 320 of IPC. Now the next category is if a person is giving a hurt, even a simple hurt, to anyone voluntarily, then the punishment will be for 1 year and a fine of 1000 rupees or both. So even if the person is making a hurt voluntarily, there is a punishment which has been described under section 321, and the punishment has been described under section 323 of IPC. Now if there is a punishment for simple hurt, voluntarily causing simple hurt to any person, definitely there is a severe punishment for voluntarily causing grievous hurt to anyone, which has been described under section 325 of IPC. Now, voluntarily causing grievous hurt means basically it may happen that a person may be in an anger and he wants to hurt someone else, but the weapon or but the mode which that person is using, if he or she is well aware that the thing or a substance which he is using or the gravity which has been used in such a way that it could cause a grievous hurt, and if that person is aware and then voluntarily he or she is causing a damage to another's body, that comes under the category of voluntarily causing grievous hurt, for which the punishment is 7 years or fine or both. Now the next category is related to dangerous weapon and dangerous mean. Now what comes under the category of dangerous weapon and dangerous mean? As far as weapon is concerned, it could be anything which is harmful, which could be harmful in a serious nature. That means any sort of pointed weapon, maybe a stick, maybe a knife, maybe stone, maybe pistol, anything which is a definite harm for another person, that comes under the category of dangerous weapon. As far as means is concerned, so the dangerous means could be anything. That means if a person is using fire, water, animal, any intoxicated or any harmful substance to give a hurt or a grievous hurt to any other person, or making any person to eat or swallow anything which is dangerous, or using anything in such a form which is really dangerous for that person to do so. And if any person is voluntarily using hurt, voluntarily causing hurt to anyone else by using a dangerous weapon or dangerous means, then it is an offense under section 324 of IPC, for which the punishment is for 3 years or fine or both. And if it is extended in a form of a grievous hurt by using any dangerous weapon or any dangerous means, then it is an offense under section 326 of IPC, for which the punishment is 10 years or fine or both. Now section 327 of IPC, which says that if any person is voluntarily causing hurt, here I am using hurt, voluntarily causing hurt to extort anyone's property, or making him compel or constrain to do some illegal work out of hurt, by giving him hurt. Now if I am interested in anyone's property and I want that property to be mine, or some part of the property to be mine, then if I am hurting that person to give the possession of his property to me, then also it will be in the category of section 327. And if I am compelling by giving a hurt to any other person to do some illegal work, to do any illegal job, then also it comes under the category of section 327, which is voluntarily giving hurt to another person. Then in this type of case, the punishment will be for 10 years or fine or both. Section 328 deals with giving hurt to any other person in a form of any sort of intoxication. Now that intoxication is in any form. It could be any sort. That means it could be alcohol, it could be drugs, it could be poison. That means if one person is giving any sort of intoxication to anyone else to hurt him, either to hurt him or by using that intoxication substance to make him, compel him to do an offense, then also it is under the category of section 328 only, for which the punishment is 10 years or fine or both. Section 329 deals with giving a volunteer grievous hurt to anyone to extort his property, or making him or compelling him to do an offense pertaining to have a property or to transfer his property in someone else's name. So that is also a serious offense, because here the grievous hurt has been given to do any illegal act. For that the punishment is 10 years or fine or both. So this is all about the meaning of grievous hurt and the punishment pertaining to grievous hurt. If you like the video, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. And you may also follow me on the various social media platform, that is FB page LawColleagueQ, Instagram LawColleagueQ, LinkedIn LawColleagueQ, Twitter and YouTube with the name of Dr. Priya Sepaha. And you may also visit to my website, in which you may find various notes, contemporary news, articles, blogs. And you all are welcome to write a blog on my website, that is priyasepaha.com, and you may see all the details pertaining to writing a blog on my website. So for the next video, see you soon. Bye bye.